गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, वेलकम टू अर्जुन इंग्लिश स्कूल। दिस इज द क्लास फॉर 11th स्टैंडर्ड स्टैटिस्टिक्स सब्जेक्ट, चैप्टर नंबर 4, मेजर्स ऑफ डिस्पर्शन। एंड दिस इज द लास्ट क्लास फॉर दिस चैप्टर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अबाउट द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ वेरिएशन एज वेल एज कंबाइंड मीन एंड कंबाइंड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन। ओके, इन अर्लियर क्लास I have already completed the theoretical part and formulas for this chapter. So now, from your textbook, in exercise 4.5, today I am going to start question number 2, where the daily salary of administrative staff of two companies yielded the following results: Company A, Company B. First of all, mean salary means here I am starting the sum for company A. Now mean is given, it means it is called x bar, that is 600. Standard deviation that we call S, that is 30. They ask to find out which company has most stable salary. It means here comparison between two companies, because it is the data for company A and data for company B. Here X bar is 2100 and S is 84. So you can see that they ask which company has more stable salary. It means here comparison between two. So we have to find out coefficient of variation. CV stands for comparison between two companies, two organizations, two students, or whatever. So here formula is S upon X bar into 100, again S upon X bar into 100. Now S means 30, X bar 600 into 100, and our answer is 5%. Same way, S 84, X bar 2100 into 100, and our answer is 4%. Here CV has inverse relation. It means lower the CV, higher the efficiency, and vice versa. It means higher the CV, lower the efficiency. It means here you can see that in company B there is 4%, it is less compared to company A. Means we can say that company B has more stable salary, means lower the CV, higher the efficiency. So now here we have to write one simple note that company B is providing more stable salary. Got it? So it is very simple sum for coefficient of variation, CV. Now, the next sum, that is in exercise 4.6, question number 1. I am reading the question: the information regarding marks of the students of two classes of a school is given below. Find the combined standard deviation of the marks obtained by the students. Here they have asked to find out combined standard deviation, means we have to find out SC. So we cannot simply find out SC. First of all, we have to find out X bar C. Then after, we have to find out D1, D2, and then after formula of SC. Now here they have provided division A and division B. It means first of all, number of students that we call N1, number of students N1 in division A, it is 50. In division 2, that we call N2, that is 60. Then after mean of marks means x bar 1 and x bar 2. X bar 1 is 60, x bar 2 is 48. Standard deviation S1 and S2. S1 is 10, S2 is 12. Okay, so only these information are provided to us. First of all, we have to find step by step x bar c. So formula for x bar c, this is called combined mean. N1 x bar 1 plus N2 x bar 2 divided by N1 plus N2. Now, value of N1 50, value of x bar 1 60, N2 x bar 2 60 and 48 divided by N1 plus N2 50 plus 60. So now 50 multiplied by 60, 3000. Plus 2880 divided by 110, and therefore my final answer for x bar c is 53.45. Got it? So now, first of all, I have completed x bar c. Then our next topic, next step is to find out D1 as well as D2. So formula for D1. D1 is equals to x bar 1 minus x bar c. And then after, D2 is equals to x bar 2 minus x bar c. Now, value of x bar 1, 60. X bar c, 53.45. Value of x bar 2, 48. X bar c, 53.45. So now, D1 is equals to 6.55. D1 is equals to 6.55. And now if we want to find out D1 square, then square of 6.55, answer 42.9025. Then after D2 is equals to 5.45. And D2 square, it is 29.70.25. So here it is D1 and D1 square. Here D2 and D2 square. Now, our last part. That is SC. Formula for SC in bracket. It is N1 in bracket S1 square plus D1 square plus N2 in bracket S2 square plus D2 square. Divided by N1 plus N2. That's it. So now, in under root, value of N1 that is 50. S1 square plus D1 square. S1 square means 10 square, that is 100, plus D1 square, that is 42.9025. Plus N2, 60. In bracket S2 square means square of 12, that is 144. Plus D2 square, that is 29.7025. Simple. Divided by N1 plus N2 means 50 plus 60. So now, in under root, 50 in bracket 100 plus 42.9025, 142.9025, plus 60 in bracket 144 plus 29.7025, it is 173.7025. Divided by 50 plus 60, that is 110. So now, in under root, 50 multiplied by 142.9025, 7145.125, plus 60 multiplied by 173.7025, 10422.150 divided by 110. So now, after solving this, answer is 159.7025 in under root. So now, my final answer for SC, that means we have to press the under root button in calculator, and our final answer is 12.64. That's it. So you can see that here it is the lengthy formula, but the process is very simple. That first of all, we have to find out X bar C, then after D1, D2, and then after formula of SC and its simplification. So finally, this sum is over, and also this chapter is over. So now, from the next class, I'm going to start a new chapter, chapter number 5, skewness. And if you have any doubts in this chapter, please contact me. Thank you.